everybody, it's the coach, and this is Monday Night Football on EA Sports.
Okay, coach, thank you. On a cold night at the foot of the Rockies, EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to Empower Field at Mile High in Denver, Colorado. Tonight, we pivotal week 14 with a great Monday night matchup between the Atlanta Falcons and the Denver Broncos. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by the third overall pick of the 2008 draft, the man they call Matty Ice, quarterback Matt Ryan.
Always knew he'd be a gym rat, very cerebral player, a guy that beat you to his mind as well as his physical attributes. And the best part, poise under pressure. He knows how to bring a team back in the fourth quarter.
Well, that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be let and drop behind the line. Well, that was a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
And sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is. Offense and defense, in this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Ready,
line of scrimmage, the 37 on
big
first
stop,
and 10.
Big, big stop, let's go!
Connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. That throw good for four. It's second down. And here's the offense now, Charles. Here's the guy you chose to highlight.
The tone setter, the guy in the middle, Alex Mack. His return, never good for the opposition.
Ryan leads with three on the ball. They see right through that defensively. As he'll be hit and taken down the backfield. A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. Charles, what could the offense have done to adjust to the calendar?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out, you see, and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. You change the blocking schemes, maybe you get a max protection. The biggest ones maybe bring your running back in and try to keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
First and 10 at the 34.
Just like that. Let's go.
They'll run for the first time with Philip Lindsay. Just a yard on the first down. Can race on second and 9. And this whole line is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Let's go. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
See some changes in the offseason, whether it's through the draft, free agency, maybe even both. They definitely need some help in the secondary.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Here's
catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Get it.
first down. It's Lindsey. And he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple. And that will get a stoppage here. There appears to be an injured Falcon on the field. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver.
15-1.
And second down, a run with Lindsey. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So,
because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they should pass in formation. That's good job there, creating the contact, the first incompletion. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not pump the ball again.
First down. It's DeJarra. They'll have a first down past the 40. A big time play there for the Falcons. 51 yards. What a luxury to have a tight end that can not only catch it, but then can run after the catch like that.
What was the old expression back in the good old days that they used to carry pianos on their backs when they were after they caught the football? Someone would stop and bang out a tune along the way as well. But nowadays, these guys are essentially bulked up wide receivers, and they are a full part of the passing game, and we see a lot of big plays as we just saw there.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Lines going to get the Freeman on the ground. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stepped behind the line of scrimmage. The defense showing some anger after giving up the big play. This time they'll lose one or two. On second and 12, Ryan got his man. That's the Pro Bowler, Julio Jones. And he'll go down. The 20-yard reception, good for 7. It's third down. In need of a conversion on third down. The big play to start the drive. Now makes sense. This one complete to Devontae Freeman. He gets 7 out of it, and he also gets a first.
Move.
Third down.
100%. A running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop it.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. Your hands get a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Field goals all with that so far. 3-3 now as the kick is away. So matching field goals on our opening two drives.
It feels like two boxers feeling each other out here in the early to end of the game. Strengths and drives, but none of the heavy stuff just yet.
Rock and the Broncos get it on first and 10 at their 25-yard line. A good run there to start the drive. 13 yards, first down. That one good for 13, and again, the first down. Reputation as a speedy runner precedes him. It's always fun to watch him
work. In addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold down for a run because he's just going to speed right past him.
And so he got it. It's Lindsay. And he'll get a couple yard shot in midfield at the 40. First down pickup of 8.
Remaining
in quarter number two. A reminder coming up just just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman, our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a more focus on the stats and scores from yesterday's action. And a quick slam as the throw is complete. And he's able to get this one across the field. Cross midfield inside the 45. Another nice game. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. This offense moving its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now the center's tied in out on the right side. It's top of the yard, short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Getting down there in the first down completion. Now the Falcons going to use regular timeouts. As they'll stop it with a tick under a minute to go before half. To tackle on the extra point. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the Bears. This will be taken in at the one. Take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. You're under a minute to go. The first half, it hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they play this?
Just run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenge on your offense right here. You know, hey guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
He has a lead to Freeman. They're getting a four on the play, and that'll make this a second down.
The reason he's able to get it so often is because of his ability to push people deep, and they have to respect that.
All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. Broncos with a lead, and they will be receiving this kickoff here as quarter three is underway. This will be fielded at the 8. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
Let's go.
Offense at the line, ready to go. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical.
I'm always of the school that until they stop you from doing something, they're going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they want to do. But the beauty is that that was a big play. Six opportunities from that place. Looks like a lot of three to play action and don't run deep. The punt reminded me a lot of the teammate of mine. He's called the trash man. He's a way to sit through traffic and make plays.
That's exactly what they're going to do. But he won't be close to a first down as he brings you to a wall. Right out of the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
It's fourth down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their
check
team.
Start moving in the other direction as they come up now, third and long. 15 passing. That's good for 87%. It's first and 10. Devontae Freeman. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. This one's away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside
go
the 5.
50, superb. Plant.
And this should be the final
up,
play before the quarter ends.
Two.
Now the first carry for the receiver. And he'll be taken down after a decent gain, and that will bring us to the end. Oh, welcome back now to Denver. Happy faces on the ground at this point. You guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four.
Get ready.
On second down now, it's Lindsey. Defense because they're facing the defenses in the league in terms of points. So they have their moments, but this offense just a little too good.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Because of what you do, you make an adjustment on defense. They have no answer for it.
Check for yourself.
Thinking about your cuts and your moves, you're just
doing
it. I think that's what we're seeing tonight. He's got to run into submission.
You took the words right out of my mouth. I'm just going to use that phrase. He's going to run him into submission.
Wade the right front.
Well past midfield. Just a yard or two shy of the 40. The Broncos first down there. 12 yards to the play. Throwing now is there.
Sometimes you can absorb the penalty when you get a big return. Then the penalty brings it back to stop their field position, as you pointed out, not in this case.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. 23 yards on the play.
And the many people like to throw to the tight end in a more flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. Slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Look
again from the 38 on second and 10.
Right, right, right. He's done right here.
That's incomplete. Turnovers and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league. It's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He's had two interceptions. I'm going to give a Scotia credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen. Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
That's it, baby. We're going to
play. Out there to start their next drive, Philip Lindsay and the Broncos. He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's Let's what you're looking for in your back, because that means everything's coming together for you. You've got guys out front of creating space. You've run through it. You've probably got some people from the other receivers. Same page, quarterback and receiver. Can't get them on the same grease board when you drive plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to start matching each other's movements.
21-yard return. It'll be a short field for the Broncos as they take over first and 10. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself. He's took out your starting quarterback out there. Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, Jonathan Taylor had three games in a row. They were brilliant ones. And if none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team to have a big lead, and each instance,
certain situations, they will take them out. But for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
And he's brought down at the 22 after a gain of two. And it was on second down. Defensively, a solid response after getting back-to-back first downs. So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Broncos, the streak lives as they move to 13-0 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the L.A. Chargers. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, it's going to all but eliminate them from the playoff picture as they fall to 5-8. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.